Oh boy, I think Palman's outnumbered. Listen, the citizens of Kavaro. The wood soldiers which attacked this town were released by the numerous army. Don't talk nonsense, says the solider. The brothers and sisters of Numeros, listen to my words. It was all plotted by Commander Zenon. Who's right behind you? Are you losing your mind, Palman? Commander Zenon, I'm as conscious as ever. You're the one who strayed out of the path of righteousness and lost your mind. Kill him! No, don't kill him. I guess this is it, Palman says. But I should have earned enough time. This is the least that I could do for her. Oh boy. Rocco says, Captain! Oh, his men! Rattel says, Captain Palman! Guys, I told you that the Palman unit was dismissed. Dorku says, you told us that already. But we never agreed to it. Right, says Gray. Captain, don't treat us like strangers. Guys, says Palman. Alright, let's break out of the encirclement. Yes, sir! Commander Zenon says, what's going on? You're getting bumped. That's what's going on. Retreat, says Palman. Damn, Palman, says Zenon. The soldiers of the Palman unit came, says Una. Yet we noticed. You can hardly meet a leader like him who you feel worth working for, McBain says. We should get going, too. We have to answer to Captain Palman's courage. Yes, says Forte. Alright, so I'm thinking here is a dead end. I'm just curious. Yes, it is. And we can't go back. What is it? We better escape right away. What do you mean we? You're just gonna stand there in your bread shop. All right, we are out of Kavaro, says Forte. Yes, says McBain. There are no watch guards along the road. Let's take a leap. Are you okay, Grandpa? Says Forte. This height is nothing. 1, 2, 3. Oh, my back, says McBain. See, you're old, says Forte. I am cool. Instead, we need to leave Kavaro as soon as possible. McBain's huffing and puffing. Whew, let's take a little rest. We're still not safe yet, says Forte. So, just a little, okay? You're mean, says McBain. It'll do more harm than good if we are captured. He's still huffing and puffing. We haven't even introduced ourselves yet. I think we have time to do that to Ms. Aria. Forte, you go first. Okay. Again, how do you do? I'm Forte. I saw you at the lakeside. I thought you were the lake spirit. We are the McBain Company, the Troubadours. This is my grandpa. I'm the head of the company, McBain. Nice to meet you, miss. I'm Una. And this is Jack and Rick, Forte says. Bow. Squeak. Thank you for saving me, she says. I'm Aria. I sometimes come around here, but this time I encountered something terrible. McBain says, we happened to find out that the numerous soldiers are trying to capture you. I have an idea why you were targeted. After a strange turn of events, I was able to receive cooperation from people in Numeros with a different take on all this, as well as from the people of Kavaro. For and on their behalf, we come to rescue you, so you can count on us to bring you someplace safe. Where should we head to now, then? Thank you, she says. Then to the west. Let's go toward the west. So we can go toward Marcha for now, right, says Forte? Aria slowly nodded. Good. Let's get going now, says McBain. Aria joins the party. And she has a hazel rod. I'm just gonna dequip it so we can see the explanation or description of it. Rod made of hazel tree. Cheapest rod readily available. Let's see, we need to get you a better rod, don't we? Okay, so her finishing move is Soul Voice, a singing voice that rocks the soul. Those interfering sustain damage. Cool. Skills, she has Charity. An enveloping heart of charity raises the effect of recovery. And resonance spell? Does she have resonance stones? I mean, I wouldn't think that she would. No. But it says... that she has a resonant spell of revive. A spell cast by the phrase of life heals one ally moderately. Contellect, cast by the phrase of purification, detoxifies one ally. Recovery, cast by purification, releases one ally from the effect of spell. And awakening from the phrase of love, ooh, recovers one ally from unconsciousness. That's great. Because before, I think we only had items to do that with. So that's going to be very valuable. And that's it. That's all we have to see for her. You can see her stats there. Okay. So I'm going to save and make sure we don't save over anything. That's the end. Wait a second, no. That's the end. If we return to Kavaro, we'll be arrested. I'm sure they remember our face. Yep, yep. Just wanted to see what they would say. Looking around. It goes in a big circle. There's a big old rock. Does that go off the map, or it does? You didn't take all the paths, I just wanted to make sure there's not a treasure chest or something that we had missed. We're finally out of Kavaro. Wow. That was a major stopover. Okay, there's this old man just hanging out here. He looks like the item merchant, doesn't he? It's a general shop. I don't know why, but I can't enter Kavaro. I'm such a wimp. I decided to do business here instead. Really? stuff that we already have. We'll actually get a better rod for Aria. Fir rod? Rod made of fir tree. Easy to use. Most common type of rod. Okay, probably getting that. Let's see what else he has. Yeah, we're definitely getting just that then. Look at that. We can increase your rod. We can improve your rod already. Wow. Her attack goes up by 48 points? Nice. And we'll sell the other one back to him. Sweet. All right. Hope you get your cojones up soon. All right, that's what I didn't want to miss. Good thing she has a much better rod now, so that's worth it. Winding path, huh? Did we come from here? No. Alright. Let's make sure I didn't miss anything. There's a few branching paths. Over here, then. Nothing? Supposed to put chests in these little areas, you know. You have failed to do so. I am very disappointed. That's a huge area. Okay. Alright, there's nothing special along here, then. All right, I need to get past you guys. Thank you. Oh, we got this thing. And that goes off, okay. And this goes back around. I think we should try that fourth challenge. It's crazy because they're so much harder than the actual rest of the game. Alright, I'll be right back and then we're gonna do that. Alright, so looking at this, I see Aria's level 15. And the rest of us are 18 and 17. What are you gonna do? These are tough battles, though, so... Forte should be alright. Let's get Jan and Rick up to snuff here. Okay. Oh, check it out, Aria. It's the middle guy, I think. Eden Shrine. I know we did this one. And this one. Not sure about this one. We didn't do that one. Eden Shrine. No. Didn't I say no? I thought I hit no. Alright, so we don't really have a choice. Even though this thing doesn't want to fight us. Oh. Are we fighting this boss? Eden and Wind Spirit? Alright. Oh, we have things though. We have full meters. Look at that. Okay, so Forte. Try to put down. Hold on 1 second. Hopefully you can hear me alright. Okay, good. So I was only getting my voice coming through the right headphone there. That's some weird music. Alright, let's put Wind Spirit A to sleep, if possible. And should we just deal with what Eden does until we... Let's fight Eden, yeah. Let's see if this will work. Ah, missed. Zero. Interrupt, Wind Spirit B. That did damage. No, interrupt. Ah! Interrupt! Interrupt! Oh, he's paralyzed. He can't do it. McBain interrupt himself. Oh, well. Okay, so we... We've only got two people. Okay. Oh, we don't have... We don't have Aria with us. Aria can't fight with us? Yeah. I figured with an extra person it would be a lot easier. Well... Especially with her ability to bring us back from unconsciousness. You know, we gotta use the restore snuff again. Oh, not restore snuff. No, they're paralyzed, that's right. Luna might be a goner, we might have to revive her. Neutralizes poison. Q Cures paralysis. Lackety paste. Before Tang. Interrupt Eden. We can't? I was clicking it like crazy. Oh, that's right. He's paralyzed. He can't do finishing move. Okay. So she's out. Forte is back. Forte... Lackety paste on generic. I want that charge dog. Charge dog. I'm trying to take one of these wind spirits out too. Seem to be working out for me. What does he have? Thunder Run, Thunder Shine. Raging Lightning damages all enemies. This damages one enemy. This binds. Well, I think we're trying to take a target out of the battle for now. Let's try Wind Spirit A again. Charge dog. We gotta bring Una back too. Oh boy. Crap. Restore snuff. McBean. And Paro Paro cure on Janerick. I don't want Electro Cube. Oh, damn. Really? Oh, is he paralyzed? Oh. Yeah. Okay. Why do you make me wait so long? Okay. I don't know if we can buff up or something. Let's go in there first. Identifies an invisible enemy. Raise the defense power of one ally. But we have to wait until we're in combat. Oh. Maybe we'll get lucky with the RNG. Maybe we can put one of those to sleep. Or two of them to sleep. The spell just missed. Yeah. Okay. Lullaby. Wind Spirit A. Critical hit rate. Raises the evade power of one ally. Doggy to heal. Alright, we'll try to bind Wind Spirit B. So one to sleep, one bind. Hopefully both, or at least one, will work. What else can he do? Really, just cure. Hunt item. Wait. I wanna look at that. Roar. Makes monsters scared. If he roars at it after it, we put it to sleep, it's gonna wake up, right? Alright, just attack Eden, I guess. It doesn't work. Interrupting. Interrupt. Oh, I messed that one up. Did McBain do his bind thing? I missed that. Try again. Bind Wind Spirit B. Wind Spirit A interrupting. Charge dog. Evil Wave Warp? Oh, crap. Alright, we're messed up right now. So we try to heal ourselves or resurrect our fallen comrades? I don't know. Fully restore his HP. He'll use it on himself. And then Una. He has a full meter too. Maybe I can interrupt somebody. She should use an item too. I don't think heal too will give back everything. Oh, considerably? Well, I guess considerably is more than moderately. We only had one cure bottle in. Interrupting Eden. So he doesn't get to go, right? Because he did the interrupt? Yeah, I thought he could still go. Restore snuff. On Forte. She might not make it. Confusion? Missed. Okay. No, no, no. Let her go. He missed. Let her go. Oh, they missed. That was lucky. Okay, we gotta bring someone back, right? It can't just be two of us. Even though I'd rather his hit points be higher than that. Restore snuff on Janerik. And Una. Restore snuff on McBean. Electrocute. Don't kill us. We're trying to come back. Are you kidding me? 8 hit points? Evil wave warp. Okay. Goodbye, cruel world. Yeah. I'm pressing start repeatedly. Start, start, start. Buttons, buttons, buttons. Maybe it's buttons. They just want to sit there listening to it and watching our failure. Alright, I'm going to try it again at the next fork, whenever that might be. Okay, that's us. It's so much harder than the rest of the game. It's like a completely different challenge. Marcha. Una says, "We arrived at Marcha. I think we can breathe a little easier now." "We should keep that Commander Zenon guy on his toes," says McBean. "So we'd better leave this village right away." "I hope Captain Palman's okay," says Una. "I wonder if he could leave the town safely," says Forte. McBean says, "Captain Palman risked his life and became a lure for us. We can't waste his kindness. Don't worry, he'll outrun them. We won't be able to let our mind drift until we bring her to the safe place." "Well, where to from here?" "To the north part of the prairie," says Aria. "Aria? The north part of the prairie?" says Forte. "Is your home in that direction?" Aria nodded slowly. "Let's check it out on the map," says McBean. McBean opens the magic map. Spinning cave? Grass barrier? Tamblin Road? Ecule? Heard about Ecule, Madron Road, Giraffe. It's an actual town, Giraffe. Shayla Road, checkpoint. Oh, there's the Grim Bridge that we were hearing about. Another checkpoint, Yellow Sand Way, Oasis. Yellow Sand Way, Enid. And Selbart. Aroma Road. That's what we're just on Aroma Road. I didn't even know it was that. So where? Grass barrier? Is that the prairie? The grass barrier? "Look, there are two resonance stones," says Una. "One comes from the north part of the prairie in Marcha," says McBean. I missed something. It clicked twice. Sorry about that. What does this mean? It's inside the backbone of the great serpent. Wait, is it above the backbone? Una says, the backbone of the great serpent is the one over there, but no one has gone over it, am I correct? Forte says, so Aria, your house is on top of that mountain range, they say together. McBain says, well, since the Numeros are looking for you with blood in their eyes, there must be some reason for it. I won't ask you more, though. Okay, let's go to the north part of the prairie. Marcha. Okay, I'm gonna call in an episode here. I mean, I'm tired of talking. Thanks so much for watching, guys. See you next time, and always seek adventure.